Hey everybody, Unstable Gamer here, and welcome back to the channel. In this video, we're going to be taking a look at Mr. Sinister. He's one of the Marauders, and as you can see, we've got four Marauders now. Sabretooth, Mystique, Mr. Sinister, and then Strife. Strife is on his way, but Mr. Sinister, we're going to go ahead and do a character profile on him, take a look at his kit and everything, and then I'm going to take these guys into Blitz, take a look at animations and what synergies they have there. So we're going to have quite a bit of fun with this, but first, before we do, if you're just now finding this channel and you want to stay up to date with this and other games, consider hitting that subscribe button so you don't miss out. All right, and welcome back. All right, so I'm going to continue to test a theory here. It was theorized that opening up Red Star Orbs might give you better odds before you unlock the character. So we did it last time. I didn't really see a difference. We did get a nice pull when we unlocked the character, but the Red Stars were kind of eh. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and unlock 10 of these and see if we get anybody good. And the reason for that is because with the Red Stars, there's always a higher percentage chance to get a new character when a new character is introduced. So that is what we're gonna do right now. We've got 10 Red Stars to go, so we're gonna go from 34K down to 24K. And let's see if we get anything good. Let's see if we get a good pull. What do we got? Right off the bat, who we got? We got a 3-star trooper. All right, come on. Upgrade. 3-star duplicate there. 2-star, not getting anything. Anything. You know, I'm gonna take it down just a little further. All right, let's keep going. It's not down to, it's not 34 to 24. It was, what, 34 to 14 is what it is. All right, let's keep going. Oh man, only two more after this. Duplicates. That was it. That was it. We got nothing. We got junk. That did not help out. I got a 2-star Invisible Woman. I'm not really too happy with that. We did open up 10 of them. Math was a little off on that one. So, nothing for Mr. You know what? Let's just go back in. Let's just use them all. Let's see if we get a Mr. Sinister at all. No. Nothing. I know I'm speeding through this pretty quick. Using up all my Red Stars. And we are not getting a Mr. Sinister at all. Hey, there we go. We got a 2. And the final one. In a pit of desperation there, we hit a 2 Red Star. Ah, okay. I don't know. That theory is not panning out too well for me. All right, let's go to Mr. Sinister here. We got 55 orbs. Just need a few more. We need 45 more. Let's see if we get any better pulls here. Right off the bat, we get a 6. Ah, we got a 12. That's pretty cool. Last time we got like a 60, I think. A 6. That took a second. Another 12. What's this? A 10. Nothing fantastic. Usual stuff. I got another 10. We got one or two more, don't we? Oh, what do we got? We got some gold over there. 72K doesn't really do much for us. All right, so what do we got? We got 70 pieces of him, and we've got some gear material and a little bit of gold. So let's go ahead, unlock him. Recruit. He's got a pretty cool character model, actually. All right, so there we go. Take a look at his character model here. He's one of those Marvel characters I don't know a lot about. I would say I'm pretty familiar with some with comic books, Marvel, DC, all that stuff. But this guy, I just never really learned too much about. All right, so that is Mr. Sinister. Let's go ahead and get him trained up. We're gonna go up to what? You know what? I am gonna just take him up to level 60 for right now. That's my usual anyway, so let's go ahead and do that. 1.3 million. Ah! You know what? Usually I take a... I'm a little click happy today. Usually I take a... You're going to have to rewind half a second and pause to see the difference. But, you know, we went up to 1838 from what we were at a couple hundred. All right, so what we're going to do now is I'm going to go ahead and get him up to gear tier 9. I should be able to do that, and then we're going to get all of his abilities at 6, 6, 6, and 4. We'll take a look at his kit, his stats, and then we'll take the team on into Blitz. So give me just a second, and I'll see you when I'm done. All right, and there we go. So I went just a little bit further this time because I wanted to get him a little bit closer to where the other Marauders are when I put him into a team on Blitz. So I took him up to gear tier 10. We got him up to 6, 6, 6, and 4. And let's go ahead and take a look at his traits. So he's a villain, global, mutant, marauder, and support. They got rid of the flavor text here. And I don't know, I really like that. I think this is where the spot's going to go for mods when they come to the game. But that flavor text was kind of cool. All right, if we go ahead and look near. So Mr. Sinister is a master of genetics, capable of cloning enemies for his nefarious needs. I guess it's right there. I guess I never really even paid attention to it, but there it is. All right, I'm cool. All right, his health is at a healthy 74K, damage is at 4304. Where are we at? His focus is at a 1769. He is a support. So let's see, what else? What's his speed at? He's at 100, so it's on the lower end of the speed spectrum, so to speak. And then there's the rest of his stats right there. Let's go ahead and take a look at his abilities. So Psionic Beam, attack primary target for 250% damage plus 50% damage per non-cloned Marauder ally. Gain an assist from a random cloned ally, and then 70% chance to gain an assist from a random Marauder ally. If we take that up to level 7, you're going to add 50% damage to the primary target, and you're always going to gain assist from a random Marauder ally. So for this one here, we're adding that additional damage to the primary target, and we're going from 50% up to... No, we're going from a 70% chance to gain an assist up to 100% chance. Minimal increase in this ability. So for me, I would just leave this at a level 6. That extra 50% damage, it's a support. You're really not depending on support for damage. And as far as that assist, it's always nice to get that assist. It's a 70% chance. More often than not, you're going to get that assist anyway, so it's just not worth the 180 orange material, in my opinion. Gene Therapy is next. Clear heal block from the two most injured allies and gain offense up for 2 turns. That could come in really handy, especially when you have a heal block. You got somebody that's almost dead. You can go ahead and clear that. And you're going to transfer all positive effects from an ally Mystique to this character. Spread all positive effects from this character to 3 mutant or cloned allies. So that is really cool. So with Mystique being a Marauder, and you throw, so we're going to have what? We're going to have Sabretooth, we're going to have Mr. Sinister here, we're going to have Mystique. We don't have Strife yet, so we need 2 other ones. We can throw 2 other mutants in there in order to take advantage of this ability right here. If we take that up to a level 7, spread all positive effects to all mutant or cloned allies, and then you're going to gain 500 healing and plus 5% healing. Now, correct me if I'm wrong, and definitely let me know in the comment section below, but I don't think we currently have an ability in the game that spreads positive effects. We have abilities in the game that spreads negative effects and prolongs negative effects, but I don't think we have anything in game that spreads positive effects. Feel free to let me know and correct me in the comment section below. But okay, so if we go transfer all positive effects from an ally to this character and then spread all positive effects from this character to 3 mutant or cloned allies, or cloned. Mutant or clone. So your entire team, if you've got some clones and you got some mutants, to spreading all positive effects, you're adding that healing and that 5% healing. Now, without putting this into play yet, and when I do my T4 guide for the Marauders, I'll definitely have a better understanding of this. But for right now, for me, I think this is worth it. I think it's going to be worth the 220 orange material to spread those positive effects across your entire team. Wow, I think that's cool. Heal all allies for 1500 health to plus 15% of this character's max health. Heal all clones for 1000 health plus 5% of this character's max health. So by spreading all those positive effects, and you're bringing that healing up to 2000, you're bringing this percentage of healing up to 20%. Oh my gosh. And what? This should bring that up to 1510% there. I think overall, it's a really, really good ability. And it doesn't say, so like when you're spreading negative effects, it says spreading negative effects except for stun. This doesn't have a limit. This does not have any stipulation like that, it seems. So all positive effects are fair game, which I think is very, very cool. So again, I would definitely put into this ability. All right, and then we have clone. So summon a clone of the primary target. This clone scales with Mr. Sinister's stats instead of the primary target. Clone gains defense up for 2 turns. On war defense, and you know what? I've got kind of my own thoughts around all these war defense characters, because essentially, you put these characters into a team and you throw them into war defense, you're really not playing them. You're not getting the benefits. Well, you're getting the benefits, but you're not playing them. You don't get the enjoyment of playing these characters. So that's just kind of my 2 cents on these war defense teams. However, on war defense, generate 2 ability energy for all marauders and cloned allies. Wow, that's pretty cool. We go ahead and take that up to level 7, +1 to all ability levels for this character's clone. So if we're at 666 and 4, then it's going to be a 777 and 5. And depending on the clone, that could be good, could be bad. I don't know. For that, for me right now, +1 ability levels across the clone, I would save on this one for me right now. Now, I may be crazy, but we'll find out once we get to play test the character a little bit. For right now though, I think I would save that 240 orange material. There's just not enough to this. And if you're not going to If you're not going to play the character anyway, why? All right. Mutant geneticist. On spawn, generate 3 ability energy for this character if non-cloned. On turn, heal 15% of max health plus 5% of max health per marauder ally. Apply regeneration to the 2 most injured mutant allies. And then on Marauder's ally turn, if this character's health is greater than 50%, redistribute 10% health from this character to that ally. And gain 30% focus. Marauder's ally gains 30% focus. Gain plus 10% health, and Marauder allies gain plus 10% max health as well. There's a lot to this one. And then on war defense, Marauder's allies gained plus 20% max health. Very nice. Plus 20% max health. That's crazy. That's nice. All right, so if we take that up to level 5, you're gonna add 20% focus to self and marauders. You're gonna add 10% max health for self and marauders. And then on war defense, you're going to add that 10% max health for marauders and allies as well. So you're gonna take that focus up to 50% focus for yourself and marauders. And then you're gonna take that max health up to plus 20%. If you're going all in on war and you want the best Marauders team you can have, I would put into this. But if you're not really huge in on the war side, I would probably skip this one. But there we go. We'll see. We'll play around again. And when I do, like I said, when I do that T4 video, we'll see if any of that changes. But those are my recommendations there for now. All right, so now let's go ahead and head on over into Blitz. I haven't even been in there yet, but let's go ahead. Yeah, that was good, right? You guys all understood that? We're gonna head on over into Blitz and check out Mr. Sinister's animations there. So I will see you over there in just a minute. All right, so here's what I decided to do. I got the 3 Marauders, so I got Sabretooth, Mystique, and Mr. Sinister, and then I decided to throw 2 mutants on there, and just because of the synergy between Colossus here and Wolverine. I thought it would be fun. So that's what I did. We got quite a bit huge spread. We got 3 in the mid 30s, and then we got 2 at 27K. We'll see how we do here. We're still fairly low in the tiers, so let's go ahead and jump in there. All right. So let's do that at a times 3 for right now. Let's go. We're just gonna get rid of the healer, or no, we'll get rid of Crossbones. And then, sure, why don't we do this one? All right, here we go. Our first Mr. Sinister. So what do we have? We have summon a clone of the primary target. This clone scales. All right. We have clear heal block. We don't have to worry about that right now. Then we have attack primary target. And let's see. I'm going to go ahead and get a... I'm going to make a clone of their crossbones. Let's see what that looks like. Oh, look at that DNA strand. That's pretty cool. Wow, yeah, he's got a decent amount of health there too. He's also got the two defense up. Very nice. Let's go ahead and get rid of him now. All right. Take it up to a times three. And look at, he's got all the abilities too. So unlike Mysterio, when he gets taken out, he's got two clones that has very basic moves. This guy, he's got all of their moves. So this is very cool. All right, so let's go ahead. I'm gonna save, I'm gonna explode. Let's go ahead, we're gonna gain taunt over here. Look at this, gain taunt, gain counter, apply two deflect. Oh my gosh, let's do this, boom. There we go. And let's go ahead and do this. And we're gonna explode as soon as we get to crossbones. We're gonna go ahead and do that. All right, so what is this? Look at all these, attack primary target. We wanna, here we go, transfer all positive effects from an ally Mystique to this character. Spread all positive effects from this character to three mutant or cloned allies. So we're gonna get some defense up. I'm gonna do that. Let's do that. Holy cow. So we got Mystique over there. Let's do this. Oh my gosh, look at that. That is so cool. That is very cool. I mean, all these deflects and defense ups. Oh my gosh. That's fun. All right. Let's explode. All right, now we're going to go ahead. Sure, why not? We'll do this. I mean, oh man, this is cool. I'm having fun with this. Oh, shoot. You know what? Oh well, we'll get that on the next one. All right, so here's my thought process on this one. So I'm gonna go ahead, let's go ahead and do this. I'm gonna go ahead and clone their Scarlet Witch. Let's go ahead and clone Scarlet Witch. And then, with the bleeds I just did, prolong them right here. Let's go ahead and do this. Let's do this for the heck of it. Oh, I wonder if he... Stealth has got to be... Yeah, look at this. I'm going to try this. I'm going to see if stealth is going to get... Nope, stealth did not get. So it's not all positive effects. So there is some limitations to it. So that's good to know. And then even at this, look at this. You steal Scarlet Witch. That's just fun. That was fun. Oh man, okay. So I can't wait. I need to get this team higher up in Blitz to see how well they do against the higher level Blitz teams, but also could be very, very good for Arena. So we'll see. Let's see, we're gonna work on Danny Rand over there. Oh, that almost took him out. I'm gonna clone this guy. Because Danny's not going to do anything for me. So might as well clone this guy. Let's go ahead and get a taunt up. So let's, I'm not going to do the DNA strand just yet. Let's go ahead and take a look at his basic. So, it's pretty basic. There's an assist there. Alright, so we have seen all of his attacks now. So let's go ahead. Let's see if I can do this. Nope. Boom. One and two. At least we got two hits on there. Didn't do much damage, though. Let's do this. Now I'm going to do Mr. Sinister's thing. All right, let's go ahead and do that. And let's do fastball special. Boom. Then work on him, and there we go. So no real heal on the team, though, right now. But very cool and fun team to play around with right now. All right, and there you go, everybody. That's what I had for you tonight. Just a video to go over Mr. Sinister, take a look at his kit, give my suggestions on Orange Material, and take a look at his animations and everything in Blitz. Very fun team so far. Fun character to play around with for sure. So really looking forward to continuing to build up that team and see how well they do in the higher levels of Blitz as well as in Arena. So there you go, everybody. All right, as always, I want to thank you all for taking the time to watch the video. If you liked it, make sure to hit that like button and share your thoughts and questions in the comment section below. Take care, everybody, and we'll talk to you next time.